Welcome, this is the Energy Vibration, a reading for the Aquarian Sun, Moon and Rising sign for the month of August 2017. The month of August, we have the energy vibration of the Hermit. The Hermit is the energy vibration of the Pisces people, and it's the energy of reaching inwards to find out who you are as a spiritual being on this planet. It's a very positive energy. It is in the sense that you will be connecting with yourself. You're trying to empower yourself. You're trying to find out who you are. You're calling up on your angels and guides in the spirit world, the intergalactic beams, and the cosmic beams are going to be working. And the ascendance masters, the goddess, the rays, all of these spiritual beings who are working with the ascension process are going to start coming in the month of August, because they started in the month of July. August has the zodiac energy vibration from the fire and the earth, which is wonderful, because whenever a month as this, which is going on with spirituality, whenever you are dealing with spirituality, whenever you're healing your inner self, whenever you're healing, when you heal what is inside, then you heal the outer side, then you will see positive new endeavors are coming true. Okay, so whatever the aspect, whatever the situation is, you are going to see real positive things coming in, and this is going to be profoundly wonderful. So again, for you Aquarians, it is going to be a positive month, in the sense that you're going to see and feel so much new changes coming in your life. The months are with three layers, because the intergalactic beams and the spirit guides are all here. The changing of the guard is happening for a lot of people. Your focus is going to be the Two of Wands. The energy of the Two of Wands is going to be your focus for this month of August, you Aquarians. The Two of Wands is seeing clarity, bringing clarity, okay? What is happening is the Two of Wands is that a portal is opening. And for you Aquarians, especially the people who are psychic, this portal is going to connect you with your spirit guides and your intergalactic beams on the other side. And you are going to see that they are going to help you to change your life and change your energy vibration. Okay, so remember, the positivity is that you are going to be connecting with your angels and guide, and this is going to help you. A lot of new doors of opportunities are going to be opening up for you Aquarians, because the energy of the foxes actually work. I don't know why they use the fox for work, but I can understand because why they use the fox for work. But you know, whatever is happening, new doors of opportunities, new work is going to, new things are going to be opening up in your life for work. Okay, so whatever that was happening, work, a new possibility for work, new endeavor for work is going to open up in your life, and this is going to be extremely positive. Okay, so if you were looking for a promotion, if you were looking for work, this is going to be the energy vibration in August, that the possibilities are there and the doors are going to be opened up. All you need to do is walk through. It's as if the universal angels are going to provide that you find that place that you want to walk through, and you're going to see a perform positive change at the end of August for you. In the month of August, we have 5 weeks, five long weeks. It is always July, but it comes in August as five long weeks. Whatever the situation is, and whatever situation that was happening in your life, you're going to see positive change. There is all four elements. The first week we have the earth, the second week we have water, the third week we have fire, the fourth week we have your energy, the third week we have, fourth week we have your energy vibration. So for you Aquarians, the fourth week is going to be the best, one of the best weeks for you guys, because in that week you have the energy of your own energy vibration being in that week. The fifth week is going to be a week where new possibilities, positive, being victorious over things, and positive things are going to come out, but it's going to come out via the energy of your psychic. The moon energy is going to help you to bring out this sort of a thing. So you need to be understanding of where you are. Let's break down the weeks. In the first week, we have the Sun of Swords in reverse. The Sun of Swords in reverse. And who is the Sun of Swords? The Sun of Swords is the energy vibration for the Sun of Swords is the energy vibration for the knight, the page of the swords, okay? Because it's the Sun of Swords, and that is the energy vibration for the page of swords. These are, it's never begin, if you're a card reading, never use these decks to begin reading your cards. They can be very complicated. So the Sun of Swords is in reverse. So whosoever, the spying, whatever that was going on, it has ended. It has ended, but be aware, when things like these ended, if you have been doing it or someone else have been doing it at you, it has been ended, but be aware that you're going to have a lot of enemies. So be aware of what is going on, okay? The energy of balance comes in to help you. The energy of balance come in. So if you were someone who was spying on someone else, be aware, because if that person found out that sort of a thing, it's going to cost a huge situation, problems that is going to come in your life, whatever it was. Okay, be aware. What is happening also is that the energy of your health and money, be aware of what is happening, because whosoever is spying on you, it's always is a jealousness of what you have and that sort of a thing. And whosoever is looking at you and whosoever is trying to spy at you, the balance, you need to balance out the situation, balance out your health and money. This energy, the tree, is a tree of life, but it also means it is the tree of life. What is the tree of life? It is also your health and your financial world. As you look at this, this can bring you wonderful changes. And this is going to bring you wonderful changes. But I will give you another reading at the end of this reading, because there is something you need to be aware and have balance between work and your health. Work on your health, because it is a situation where I'm getting that some people are going to be overworking themselves, going too far, and not looking at what your health is doing, your bodies, because sometimes your body is giving off signals and you're not listening to your body, and you need to listen to your body. There has to be a balance between work and play, okay? In the second week, we have the Ace of Pentacles, and this is wonderful. So whatever situation that is happening in the second week, you have the Ace of Pentacles. Whatever is happening is that a lot of people is going to find love. Anything that is the Ace is always new love, and this can be new love with someone who has a lot of money. Yeah, and this can be new endeavor. Your health, your emotion is going to be, you're going to be finding the love of your life. And again, this person could have money for some people. So this is going to be wonderful, because you'll be connecting with people. You'll be finding your true love, because this week is a week of love. So you'll be finding your true love, and it can be a love for money, which is here, but it can also be a love for emotional wealth and emotional health, and this is also good. Whatever is happening, be aware and stay out of a certain situation, because there is going to be conflicts. Whatever conflicts there was, it's about to end. Whatever conflicts it was about to end, because it's in the reverse form, so it's about to end. So whatever conflicts there was, it's about to end. Okay, and there's a healing that is going to come in the fourth week. So you have the Ace of Pentacles in the second week, and Ace of Pentacles is new things. So if you had a relationship with someone, this is going to change, okay? Whatever the conflict was in that relationship, was it about money? It is going to change, okay? In the third week, we have the energy vibration of the devil. And the third week is also a fire week because you have the energy vibration of the devil. But whatever the energy of the devil comes up to, it's not going to happen because the tower is going to break it down. I love this. Yes, whatever the devil is up to, it's not going to happen because the tower is really breaking it down. So, whoever has planned and decide to do something and you know it's wrong, but yet still you're trying to get through with a devious act, it's not going to work in the third week. The third week is a fire zodiac energy and you are a water energy. Be aware of what you are about to do because it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen, people. It's not going to happen. It's going to be blocked. And this blocked. So whoever you are as the energy vibration of the devil or whatsoever that is about to happen to you, it's not going to happen because the tower is going to come down and the universal angels are going to break this, whatever this devil energy was about to do. Okay, so be aware of this. If you are going to try to do something to someone, it's not going to happen because the universal angels for that person is going to come through and blow up something. And whatever it's going to happen, it's going to be blocked. It's not going to happen. So be aware of the energies that you're carrying in for yourself. Because this is going to be totally, totally break. It's going to be broken. Off broken. Okay. As we look at your fourth week, you have the energy, and I really, 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 sorry people, but I need to put on my glasses. You're going to have the energy of, this is the four of wands. This is the four of wands. The four of wands energy is a positive energy, okay? So whatever negativity, whatever block that you had, whatever negativity that you have there, whatever that was working against you, the energy of justice is going to come in and remove that situation away from you. So whoever the devil was in the third week or whatever the energy of the devil was paying in the third week, in the fourth week, whoever and whatever, justice is going to enter and break and remove those people because obviously that was a block that they were trying to do. And the tower came in the third week. And in the fourth week, justice is going to stand up. And you are going to have a success. You're going to win. You're going to triumph over whatever situation it was. And there is going to become an end to it. This is wonderful. And this is so powerful. Because whatsoever that was being done against you, the blocks, the lies, whatever that has been taking place, the blockage of your money and your energy vibration coming through and your situation, whatever is happening, justice is going to come in and you are going to have a win at the end of the day. And the end of the day, it's going to be an end to all of the negative challenges that you have in your life. As we move forward, we're looking at the fifth week. And the fifth week, we have the Ace of Swords. And this is wonderful because you have triumphant over. And this reading is just so positive. I'm going to go back to over it. But this reading is really a positive reading. I'm really seeing where this is coming from. The Ace of Wands. So you're at the end of the day, in the fifth week, you're going to be successfully triumphant and successful over it. And how that is going to happen is because you're yourself and your intuition, your guiding angels and your spirit guides are, you know, and this is what I've always said to people, whenever you're in a situation that you think, how the hell did I get in the situation? I call upon my guides and angels and the universal angels, my spirit for divine intervention in all the situations that is happening. I'm asking for a miracle for the situation. And this is what you did in the beginning of the month, and this is what is happening. You are triumphant and victorious over whatever situation it was. And this is because of the help. This is the help of whoever your spirit guides were, who came in to rescue you from this situation. And by ending and rescuing you, a lot of new possibilities and openings are going to happen for you, okay? Because whoever was lying, whatever the lie was, and whoever was lying, you can see that here you have you are victoriously successful, come over this. And by listening to your intuition and by going the way, you are going to see that positive situations, new doors of opportunities are going to be opening. Walk up those stairs and enter into that room of the unseen, because they are going to help you, Aquarians. And the people who are on the fourth and fifth dimension will understand what I'm meaning, because we as light workers and way showers, it is not one of the easiest part to walk. And this is why not everybody is a light worker and not everybody is a way shower. Even though we have a lot of people who are doing readings, that doesn't say they're doing it because it's their divine life purpose. They are doing it because they want to survive. They are doing it because of money. So whatever that's pushed them, they will know when it is a time to stop, because what is happening is only positive people and positive situation that the universe wants to send out to other people to awaken them to whatever they're doing. So whatever that was happening to you in the first week, we had a balance that the balancing, they're asking you to balance your work and life. In the second week, you have the Ace of Pentacles, and which is so beautiful with your readings, that you have the Ace of Pentacles and you have the Ace of Swords, which is positive. Ace of Pentacles is that some people are going to be working hard for money, and some people are going to receive a lot of money. Some people are going to couple up with someone who has a lot of money that is going to really help you. And whatever the conflicts that you have with someone about money, it's going to be ending in the second week. In the third week, you have the energy of the devil. Whatever the devil was there planning, the tower is going to come and break it down. There was a blockage, and this blockage is going to be removed, because in the fourth week, you have the energy of the Four of Wands. The Four of Wands is a celebration, is a triumph, and justice came in to stand in there. And whatever that was happening, there is going to become an end. Whenever you see this cross, you know whatever that you're doing, or whatever that people have been doing to you, it's an end. Okay. In the fifth week, which is wonderful, the Ace of Swords, and the Ace of Swords is here with the energy of the moon for the psychic people. It's going to be wonderful, because in the fifth week, the intergalactic and angels are here, the guides and angels, they've always been here, but so how come in the fifth week they are here, and what they're going to do is open up portals, door gates for you, so that positive energies can flow into your life. And this is going to be wonderful. So wherever you are at this moment in your life, know that whatever situation, new doors of opportunities will work, is going to come in for you guys, and it's going to be a positive month. And moving on, because we are going to look at love is going to be a perform focus in the second week. Love is going to be in the second week. The energy of love is going to come in the second week. Your best week is going to be the third week, okay? Your best week is going to be the third week. The second week, the love is going to come in. The number energies, you have 3, 7, 6. 11. It's going to be one of your numbers. 1 and 11. 1 and 11 is going to be your number. This is 8, 5. 1, 5, and 11 is going to be your number. 1, 5, and 11 is going to be your number in this month. Okay, we're moving forward and we're going to see what it is for the Sun people. What it is for the Aries Sun people in this month of August. What it is for the Sun people in the month of August. What should we know about the Sun people? Okay, what should we know about the Sun people? Okay, for the Sun people, I think, did I get enough cards? Yeah. For the Sun people, remember, it's the people who were born between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. You are going to be working with the Sagittarians, and this is good. This is wonderful for you, Aries. You two can be good lovers, good partnership. So whoever is coming in your life, it could be a Sagittarian. So what is happening here is that for you Sun people, you're going to be working with the Sagittarians people. And these Sagittarians people are going to be helping you because they are one of the people who are the most luckiest on this planet. Whatever you're about to start, or whatever endeavor, or in school, or wherever, or at the work floor, these Sagittarian people are good friends to have. Okay, they're going to come in to help you. Neptune is also here. Neptune. And your ruling planet is also here. And Neptune is a psychic. Neptune is the psychic, okay? Neptune is really, really the psychic. And I've been studying these astrological events because my guides and angels wants me to go deeper in this. And what is happening for you Aquarians, with Sun Aquarians, is that with the energy of this wonderful, wonderful planet, because Neptune and Uranus, Neptune and Uranus question authority, speak truth to power, find the words that inspire truly meaningful change in your world. Okay, so this is strange for you Sun people, because it is saying question authority, speak truth to power, find the words that inspire truly meaningful changes in your world is going to happen. And this is so, so wonderful. Another situation that is, you know, happening, and what is happening around you, because you have Neptune and you have Uranus. You have Neptune and you have Uranus. And, you know, the possibilities are not really endless, but there is a changing of the guards that is happening here. And with the energy of a Neptune, Jupiter, Uranus, that sort of a thing. Neptune with Uranus, Neptune with Jupiter, Neptune with Uranus, is what you some people will be doing is to open to perform understanding of the world soul. Let compassion for all humanity guides your action. So this is going to be a perform wonderful month for you Sun people, because it's what you're doing is really, really, really opening to perform understanding of the world, the universe, and let compassion for all humanity guides your action. And this is extremely good. This is what I'm trying to bring out, is that we find compassion and let compassion be our guides to humanity. And this is going to be extremely good. So, you know, question everything around you and question things around you. And, you know, do not just take things as granted and take things as how it's supposed to be. And question things around you and question certain things around you and try and figure out what is going on. And this is going to be good. It's going to be a wonderful month because you have Saturn, Neptune, and Uranus, which is your oh, your ruling planet. So your own ruling planet is here to help you. And this is why I'm seeing all these perform changes coming in and happening. So this is going to be good. We are moving on now to the moon people. Let's see what is happening for the moon people. Let's see what is happening for the moon people. We have Taurus, we have Pisces, and we have Mars. Wow. Okay, so remember, if you were born between the hours of 6 p.m. and 6 a.m., you have to listen to what it say, that Taurus is coming. The Taurus people are going to come to work with you, with you lunar people, the night people, the moon people. The Taurus are going to come. It's an earth energy. They're very good at business, so they're going to come in your lives to work with you. And you also have the Pisces, which I think that the Taurus and Pisces are two good business partners who, if you are looking for business partner or whatever partner it is, they're very good for you, Aquarius. And then we have the energy of Mars. Mars coming in. And I'm telling you, I don't like when Mars is in my birth chart, because it tears out things that no longer need to be there. So be aware of what is happening. So you have, you moon people have, under the Pisces and the you have to work with Mars. You lunar people, you have to work with Mars. So here we are with this lunar people, because if you're working with Mars, you know, this is a sort of a thing that you need to understand what planet you're working with, and you have control over your energy and how you spent it. Turn it towards goodwill, not anger or rage. If you go back to the general readings, this energy did came up and it says the same thing. So obviously the universal angels and guides want you to be aware of this energy, what is going on, because it wants people to start going back and see where are you spending your energies and what is happening. Because whatever is happening is that people needs to turn their energy, their focus, their energy on something that is good. You need to control and have control over your energy, the way you've spent it, and turn it towards goodwill, not anger or revenge. So whatever is happening, you Aquarius, it's going to affect you. Whatever is happening, you Aquarius, it's going to affect you. So you need to be aware of whatever is happening. With you Aquarius connecting with you Aquarius connecting with the Pisces and the Taurus people, they're going to come in as partners to you. It's going to come in as partners to you, whatever the situation is. It's going to come in as partners to you, and this is going to be wonderful, because it's going to show people situation and show up certain aspect of yourself, because the Taurus is a bull and it's the earth sign and it's governed by Venus. The Taurus is I have, you know, and the Pisces are a positive energy. What is happening and the situation that is happening to us. So this is going to be wonderful, because the water and it's Neptune, it's rule. I believe. So I have and I believe is going to be your motto for this new month. And the last card that we have is the energy vibration of the vortex. And you have our destiny supports our individuality, freedom. Our destiny support our individual freedom. While your society continue to try to dictate and enforce humans' behavior to please the majority because of your desirable, it contains to be an uncomfortable struggle that you struggle against and against. Falls of the economical weight. There is simply not enough money in the world to buckle the natural current of each individual freedom and independence of thoughts. Yeah, it can, people. It can. It's not a question. It can. So I want to say to you, Aquarians, it is not one of the easiest months for no one. It is one of the hardest months. I think after this month, I'm hoping that things will vibrate. It's the energy vibration of a lot of emotions that's going to happen in this month for you, Aquarians. But I guess we just have to work through these energies and we need to understand what is going on. And I'm wishing you a wonderful, wonderful month, and I'll speak to you next month. And I want to say to each and every person, have a wonderful month.